One, two, and three, four, two, two, three, four, three, two, and three, four, four, two, three.
Oh. Hi, and welcome to the tutorial section of this video from the piece Serenade from Don Giovanni. This is from the book Standard of Excellence Festival Solos for Trombone. Don Giovanni is a famous opera written by Mozart. It is slightly comical, slightly serious, and this piece has elements of both. In this video, we're going to talk about some of the things we do to try and make the piece sound better. The first one is there are several sections where we're using an alternate position. Instead of playing our fourth line F in first position, we're playing it in sixth. Let's go over the different times that we do that. The first one is from measures 5 to 6. This is what it sounds like when we play the F in first. In measure 6, the two notes are C and F. Instead of playing C in 6 and then coming up to first position for the F, we can play both of them in 6th. Take a look. We do the same thing for measure 10, the C going up to the F. Here it is with the C in 6th and the F in 1st. And now here's measure 10 with both the C and the F in 6th position. In measures 21 and 22, we can play the Fs also in 6th position. Take a look at what it sounds like and looks like when we play those Fs in 1st, and see that jump that we have to make from the G back to the F in 4th position back to 1st position. Here is the F in 6th position. That allows the slide to go 3rd position A-flat, down to 4th position to G, down to 6th position to F, and then we just come up to 3rd position for the E-flat. I'm going to make a confession. Measures 29 to 32, we do some of those Fs in 6th, and you may like it or you may not like it. Let me show you both of them. First of all, here's 29 to 32 with all of the Fs in first position. Now here it is, where the single Fs are in first position, but the repeated Fs are in sixth position. The reason that I'm doing this is to try and avoid a possible gliss sound from the D in fourth position up to that first F in first position. You may like it, you may not like it, but this is what I'm doing. In measures 52 and 53, this is another one of those sections that you can play around with. Here is what it looks like when all of the Fs are in first position. What I'm going to do with this one is play the first F in sixth position and the second F in first position. This allows me to use a natural slur for those last few notes so that everything sounds much cleaner. Let's talk about something that's very subtle, but if you get it right, you're gonna stand out. Here's measures 7 and 8. Please watch the metronome that's on my music stand and notice on what beat the dotted half note ends in measure 8. The dotted half note got 3 beats, correct? But it ended on beat 3. Which is really 2 full beats. When you have a dotted half note starting at the beginning of a 4-4 measure, it ends where the 4th beat begins, so you play it through beat number 4. Watch this example and notice where the metronome is when I finish that dotted half note. I said that there was some comedy or some fun stuff in this piece? Well, it occurs between measures 41 and 44. In measure 42 and 44, there are two quarter notes followed by a half rest. If you play that second quarter note too short, it's going to sound a little clipped, just like this. You can still get the comic effect and play it appropriately when you play both quarter notes for a full beat. So let that second quarter note end right at the beginning of the third beat, like this. Let's talk about one other section, and this is measures 24 to 26, specifically measure 25. The first two eighth notes are slurred, followed by two articulated eighth notes. The second two eighth notes are the same. First two are slurred, second two are articulated. When we first learn this piece, very often we will play all of those notes articulated, sounding like this. In order to play this correctly, we want to use a ta or a two tongue for the notes that we're tonguing and a do or a da sound for the notes that are slurred. So here is what that measure looks like when we tongue it. Two do two 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 do two two. Finally, this piece is in the key of E flat major. It will be very helpful for you to know how to play that scale. If you're not sure, you can go to thetromboneplace.com and look under scales and then major scales, and you will find an E flat major scale that you can play along with. Thank you so much for watching this. I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions at any time, please don't hesitate to email me at thetromboneplace@gmail.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.